Do you want early access? Do you want uncut reactions? If so, then check out our Patreon. Link in the description down below.
Yeah, so Outlaw Star. We're on to episode 7 now, Creeping Evil. Effectively, we are now in the full flux of the adventures. As we move forward, the stakes are going to keep going up and up and up. And we've also been introduced to all of the main characters of people who will be on the Outlaw Star. You know, we have Jim, we have Jean, we have Melfina, we have Aisha, we have Suzuka, and we have their assistant, you know, person who will provide them with arms, Fred Lowe.
Let's get into this.
Yeah, let's go ahead and leap in.
Shit go down.
Shit's going down.
I'm tired, so I need to get through this.
The dwarf star world where Jean resides is a measureless one. Far away from the central areas, 4 known pirate groups vie for supremacy. One of the 4 is after the Outlaw Star and Melfina to destroy them. They are called the 108 Sons, the most brutal member of the Chinese Guild. Presently, the boss of the pirates who is now pursuing Jean is called Hazanko. He has power within the 108 Stars, but because of the extent of that power, his organization and the power of the methods he employs to achieve his goals, it is said that the other leaders consider him superior. But the squads that carry out his orders use a superpower called Senjutsu and always slay those who stand against him.
Let's do it. Activating all sensor systems. CFS activated. Radar activated.
All sensors are functioning. Subreactor 1 operational.
What? What do I do, Gilliam?
Run a power balance with the remaining reactors. But Amy, they are about to explode right now.
Emergency shutdown.
He has to be dreaming this shit.
Twas only a test.
Preparing for unexpected situations are what simulations are for. If you are unable to manually respond to a small problem like this, the liftoff is probably out of the question for the time being.
Bite me!
I was going to say, I kind of have to agree with Gene here, especially if they haven't gone through a regular walkthrough of a liftoff, mm-hmm. like getting all the steps down, then that's one thing. But immediately the first time, it's just like, oh, by the way, the reactors are imbalanced. And it's like, oh, okay, they're about to explode. What? Why? And it's like, Gilliam doesn't tell him anything. It's like, if he doesn't know how to do it normally, how's he supposed to prepare for whenever shit does go wrong?
Ain't that what the computer's for?
Yeah, exactly.
Fix the shit for me.
Exactly.
Oh, welcome back.
So, anything new?
No, not really. Oh!
What about Jim?
At the police station.
Police station?
Yes. Apparently they impounded Jim's car.
The Afra? I sure don't like this. Something's fishy.
Hey, Jean!
They said she racked up too many parking tickets. I tried hard to come up with an excuse.
You should have just told them that we were attacked by pirates.
No way, they never would. You don't even know how much the fines and time cost that. It's crazy, I'm telling you.
Well, Gene was right to feel like something bad's, but like it's a bad omen.
I heard that some pirates were after you, so I just assumed that.
Uh-oh.
Thank goodness.
Iris, oh, it's okay.
I've been so worried about you.
Hand off her keister.
Iris, you sweet thing.
That's
a
sweet
talk
to you.
It's been 2 weeks. What have you been up to?
It's a long, boring story. You don't want to know.
You're bad.
Well, after that fight, it's been pretty busy in here. But nobody's asked any important questions.
I sure don't like this.
What's your problem?
It's nothing.
Melfina is not the one she should be jealous of. She should be jealous of the burned up chick that fell into the sun.
Oh, yeah. Because him and Hilda actually got together.
Maybe sell your body?
Yours would sell.
No.
IOUs. Oh. Careful, Gene. Gene.
Hey, what do you think you're doing, scumbag?
Oh, I just thought I'd see how human Melfina really is.
She's like my mom.
Oh, poor kid. Ah, boy. That's me. Just, it's like, oh, this is what Babish does.
Just how much longer will you be here?
I'm not sure.
Warning, that is not the captain.
Gene. Gilliam, what's going on?
It's an intruder.
Hey, Biggin. How you doing?
Why didn't they deny him entry?
They're at Starwind and Hawking. They're not on the Outlaw Star. Also, like, I'd be like, hey, bro.
Skip leg day, man.
Like, hey, bro. You work out? Do you even lift, bro? Sorry, just to fuck around.
Dude's shredded. He's got like an 8-pack.
What's up, Suzuka?
Visiting Starwind, and what do I find? Some of the most interesting people are trying to kill him as well.
That's lucky.
Gene Starwind is my prey. What? Stay back now.
All right.
Okay.
I'll say it again. Don't interfere with me.
Well, in that case, this is going to be a fine opportunity to put Gene in my tent.
He's fucked.
Well, yeah. I mean, come on.
I finally got to blow off some steam. You left some lookouts here now, didn't you? Huh? Am I right, Mr. Pirate?
So where is Hilda now? Answer me. Where is Hilda now?
I ain't talking.
Damn. Flashbang. Good play.
She's shooting needles, or what the hell is
basically
that?
Yeah. Just like
it's
that.
It's all right. It's over now.
Oh, okay.
Do you think it would be all right if I waited for Gene in his shop?
Sure.
I had questions to ask him, but it's too late.
Yeah, about that. Surprise!
I don't think I've seen him use that gun before.
That's the double barrel. He's used it a couple times. He also twirled it around and jammed his foot with it. Uh-oh.
Will you be a good boy and answer?
My lucky number's one. My favorite color's red. Oh.
Where's Hilda now, huh? Why did you and your friends come back to Sentinel by yourselves? What happened to my people? Answer me!
What'll I get?
I'll go ahead and grant you a quick debt.
You'll have to make me a better offer than that.
Maybe I will, depending on your answer.
Any witnesses?
Nah, no one. Apparently they're scared of getting involved.
When it comes to pirates, I guess I'd do the same thing.
Well,
damn, this sucks.
There's a big hole in the...
Tell her I'm not coming home until she's gone.
There's an ulterior motive to Suzuka.
I assume so.
It's bad, Jim. There's been trouble. Attacked by pirates.
Here, too? Where's Gene?
He's inside working right now.
All right, then. Just let us in.
Of course.
Now what?
What should we do about that young lady you brought?
Guest. She's a guest.
Just let her in for the time being.
Grant temporary access as a guest.
Hey, Gene!
Yeah, that's right. The pirates were here.
What are we gonna do?
Well, we're gonna load up all the equipment we can and launch as soon as possible.
Gene! What's the matter? What's wrong?
He got winged. Uh-oh.
Will he be okay, or will he die?
This
is not Gurren Lagann, so I believe he will probably survive.
Oh my gosh. It's like, has Gene Starwin finally reached the end of his road? Will Jim be able to save him?
Next time on the next episode of Dragon Ball.
Find out on the next episode of Outlaw Star.
And then you got Dragon Ball Z where they actually fucking kill people and it's like, this is the end for them. And then it's like, they get wished back with the Dragon Balls and, you know, the next half season.
Actually, so. I remember the original dub, like the ocean dub of Dragon Ball Z. And they said, you know, it's like, they're not allowed to say that they killed anybody. And whenever Vegeta, like, blew away, like, all those Namekians, that one Namekian was just, like, trying to tell him, stop! Don't go any further! He's like, don't ever try to stop me. And he, like, blows him away with an energy blast. And they always said, or else I'll send you to another dimension. It's like, just say you're gonna kill him, bro. I mean, what the fuck? Just...
Well, I mean, technically, like, we found out in the lore that...
It technically is.
They really do kind of just get sent to another dimension
but
whenever
Vegeta
they die.
Vegeta didn't know that because he hadn't died yet.
True.
Creeping Evil. Good episode. Good little action tidbit in there. You know, a little bit
also, what's up with Japanese using, like, jester-type characters as, like, evil villains?
Because I guess jesters, like, where clowns are, like, a little bit creepy. I don't know.
It's like one, Kefka is kind of like a jester type character and is like the main villain of a Final Fantasy entry that like was
considered like one of the best.
I can like arguably supposedly one of the most powerful Final Fantasy villains of all time.
Yeah,
like,
well, and six. And yeah, he's a fucking monster.
The dude from Hunter like gives off some really like jestery vibes.
Yeah.
Like the flamboyant like guy that's like uses the cards when he fights that's clearly like obviously on the power tier pretty high up there.
All right. We're going to have to move on to the next one real quick before it gets too late for Nick because, you know, he's...
Oh, it's already too late for me, pretty much.
It's too late for the world, man. We're all going to fucking die. So,
no shit.
Anyway, let's...
This is a fun episode.
Yeah, this was a good episode.
I can see you in the future. You're all going to die at some point.
At some point, yes. So, again, everyone, thank you all very much for tuning in. And until next time, I'm Nate.
I'm Jacob.
I'm Nick.
We'll see you, everybody. Peace out.